Very good morning to everyone. My name is Shivam Sridhar, a member of Group 1, to which the topic of diagnostics and identification of knot sources in automobiles and their reduction method was assigned. So in order to establish what the project that we did on this project, on this particular topic, we understand the need for noise identification and we understand the theoretical concepts behind it. So let's start with the introduction. So as I earlier mentioned, that introduction actually comprises of understanding the need and analysis of why we require the techniques for noise identification and other factors that contribute to it, for example, noise sources. So noise identification is required because if we see in passenger vehicles, the three basic requirements are of performance, quality and comfort. And the noise in any vibrating part or segment or any assembly in the vehicle could create noise that actually could hinder with these three aspects. So there is need for noise identification, identification techniques. Talking about different noise identification techniques, we talk about pass-by noise test, on which we have done the project, which will be demonstrated to you after the presentation. Stationary noise test, in which there is a sound meter which is actually kept near the exhaust, and the sound, the decibel level is actually measured. And we talk about beamforming, where there is an array of microphones. If you see, there is an array of microphones, and the noise source is kept in the middle, which is known as a focus, and the focus noise is actually sensed, which is called the main lobe, and then the other noises from different degrees are known as the side lobes. So it actually segregates the noise on the basis of different noise sound intensities, and it operates on the principle of delay and sum. Which brings us to understanding the other factor, as I earlier mentioned about which contributes to our understanding the need of noise identification, is identifying the noise sources. So if you could refer to the presentation, you could see these two tables, in which the first table actually analyzes the different segments and their noise contribution. So if you see, engine contributes around 20 to 35%, exhaust contributes to around 20 to 35%, and if you see intake system, it contributes around 7 to 15%. And also, talking only about engine, the thriving noises alone are due to low order harmonics of multi-cylinder engine, of the inertia force of the multi-cylinder engine, and there are other causes and their counteractive measures and their reasons also, which you could see in the table. So we'll discuss about the noise reduction technique, for which I'll hand over the presentation to Vamsi, who will talk about it. And then after that, Siddharth, Shobhit and Sudesh are going to demonstrate the project we did on this particular topic of pass-by noise test, and that will be demonstrated by them. So for now, hand over.
This is Vamsi Krishna, 13BMA0002. As my friend Shivam has explained you all about the noise identification and diagnostics, I'm going to explain you about the noise reduction. Noise reduction is of two types, and the noise comes from engine, cooling systems and many other sources such as tires. And the noise reduction can be divided into two types, that is exhaust and intake noise control and voice vibration dampening. And the exhaust and intake noise control can be done with the silencers and mufflers. And reactive silencers are the most used nowadays, and the reactive silencers is such a type that they accept the sound and they reflect the sound in the same direction, which controls the sound. And the vibration damping is of two types, free vibration damping and constrained vibration damping. Free layered vibration damping can be seen in many cars, and constrained vibration damping is much more specific with compared to free layered vibration damping. And in most recent vehicles, such as racing type of sports models, H2R and all, there you can see this reactive silencers, mufflers and vibration damping.
We are going to perform the pass-by noise test on the two-wheeler, that is FC model. For that we need a free field, which is, as you can see, there is a free field around us. Okay, so we need one entry point from the vehicle to come and one exit point. There is the entry point from where vehicle is going to come, and the vehicle is going to pass through this point from where we are going to record, and the speed of the vehicle is going to be 60 km/h.
As told by him, we are going to conduct an informal test today. So that is an informal test, but we are going to conduct it with all the standards. As for example, we checked the wind velocity, and as you can see here, it is not more than 3 meter per second. So, and the relative humidity factors, the tire pressure factor and the temperature factor, all were taken into account to say that we are going to conduct the test in an appropriate way. So what we did was, Siddharth here is gonna, what we are going to do is, Siddharth is gonna come here on the bike at the speed of 60 km/h. Me and Sudesh are gonna stand from a center line at a point at a distance of 7.5 meters from the center line. Now, what we are gonna do is, we are gonna measure the sound of the exhaust of the whole bike in the mobile microphone, as you can see there, and we are gonna check that how much noise it is generating.
Also the microphone which we are holding is supposed to be 1.2 meter above the ground. And
okay, so one of the most important thing while testing is calibration of the equipment. And as per the standard, if the measured sound and the like ambient sound has a difference of more than 16 decibel, nothing is required, no calibration is required. And here the ambient noise which when we checked was 30 decibel, and the noise we checked from our exhaust is gonna come is around 80 decibel. So there's a difference of 50 decibel, so no calibration is required.
I was the rider in the experiment. We chose this bike. This is Yamaha FC 150cc bike. This has a special silencer, which is for racing use only, and this produces a sound a little more than the normal sound produced by any of the bikes. And this has a special kind of a disc brake. And this bike is in the testing phase from the company itself. So while riding in this ground, this type of ground, it was a bit difficult for me. It took me three or four takes to complete the experiment. And because this, as you can see, the ground is a little uneven, and it took me 4 takes to ride the bike on 60 km/h. But at the end, we could successfully do it. And I drove the bike 60 km/h exactly in the middle of the two points, which was 7.5 meters. So that's it.